Hello students, hope everyone is doing well at home. In today's math session, we will be learning what is meant by congruence of arcs as well as the property of sums of measures of an arc. Also, we will be seeing the theorems which are related to these properties. So let's start with today's session. Children, before we get into the properties or the theorems, first let's see what is meant by an arc of a circle. Now, in the introduction session, already we have seen what is a secant, chord, and all the minute components of the circle. Now, to study the arc, we need to concentrate on a secant. Now, when a secant, what is a secant? It is a line which touches the circle in two different points. Now your line L is a secant which is touching the circle in two points A and B. Now when we see this, what it does is it has divided the circle into two parts. This is first part and this is the second part. And now what did we get out of it, children? Now what is an arc? Firstly, we will see. If you take the first cut part along with its end points, okay, I will get something like this, and these are the end points A and B. So this is what this is, a arc. So in the similar fashion, if you take the below part, okay, something like this along with its end points, okay, along with its end point, if you are lifting, that is nothing but a arc. Okay, the common example which exhibits into the nature is the rainbow. Rainbow is also a kind of arc. Okay, so this is nothing but arc of a circle. So when a secant cuts a circle into two parts, if you pick any of that cut part and along with its end points, that will be called as the arc of the circle. Now let's see certain more things. Now in the last example, we discussed regarding the rainbow, which is the most natural, you can say, or the easily available thing, or which many of you have observed. Now let's see, like the first part which we got upside, that was arc AB, and the below one also, the lower part of the secant, that is also an arc AB. So there are some techniques to name it or label it that we will be seeing further. The another example which everyone carries is your smile. Smile is also a kind of arc. Now let's see, these two are the arcs which we got from the same circle. Now let's see what is a major arc and a minor arc. Now children, as like we saw, a single secant cuts the circle into two parts. Then it's very simple, like the minor arc will be what? The smaller piece which you have got, that will be the minor arc. And the bigger piece which you have got, that will be the major arc. But here, while defining the major arc, how you're going to, like, you can't say a smaller piece, a bigger piece. That is good if you are able to recognize with eyes, or for your understanding, that is a good thing. But when you are defining, there is a certain way, okay? Like what you can do, the smaller arc which you have obtained, that is the minor arc. And how you are going to define a major arc, then the arc of the circle which contains the center, okay? Then that will be called as the major arc. So like here, we are having center into the second part of the circle. Okay, so A, arc AB will be the major arc. Now children, while writing the name of the arc, like in the last example we saw, here both were AB, AB. Okay, even the minor was named as AB and even the major was named as AB. So what you can do is, like here, whenever we are studying the arcs, along with the end point, certain more points will be inserted. So when you are talking about the minor arc, how you will write? You will write it as arc like AYB. Okay, this will be arc AYB, and the major arc will be like, it will be arc AXB. You have to insert a alphabet in between the two end points. So this was about the minor arc and the major arc. Major arc contains the center, while as the minor arc won't contain the center. Okay, after that we saw the labeling also. Then let's see what further we have. Further, we have a central angle. Now, a new concept which we need to use it many a times in the geometry throughout. Now, see what is a central angle. The central angle, like when the vertex of an angle. Now, what is the vertex where two arms of the angle meet? That point is called as the vertex. Then, when the vertex of an angle is the center of a circle. Like children, if you see the angle, if I talk about angle AOB, its vertex, that is where its two arms are meeting, that point is vertex and that point is lying on the center, okay? So angle AOB will be called as a central angle, okay? In the figure, O is the center of the circle and angle AOB is a central angle. Why? Because its vertex is lying on the center. Then, like secant, a central angle also divides a circle into two arcs. Like in the last example or while studying the arcs, we got secant who was cutting the circle into two parts. Now children, here you are able to see a central angle will also cut the circle into two arcs. Like here, which are the arcs which we are able to see? Arc A, P, B. See, the one part which is inside, this is one arc and the remaining part, that will be the another arc. Okay, so arc A, P, B. And another one will be arc AQB. Okay. So, like secant, even a central angle is going to divide your circle into two different arcs. Now, let's see what next we have. Let's see how to find out the measure of an arc. How you're going to find the measure of this particular arc. Okay. Like, suppose this is APB. This is APB. How to find its measure and what will be its unit? Like if you are measuring a length, it will be meter. If an angle, it will be degree. So what will be the measure of an arc? Let's see. The measure of a minor arc is equal to the measure of its corresponding central angle. Now children, just now we saw arc APB is a minor arc. And if you want to find the measure of its minor arc, it will be same as the central angle which is corresponding to it. Suppose this central angle, okay, is, that is this theta. Suppose it is 30 degree, then measure of this arc APB will also be as 30 degree, okay. So this was very easy regarding the minor arc. If you know the value of theta, the same value will be possessed by this arc APB. Then, let's move towards this measure of a major arc. Very simple. We know whole circle measures 360 degree. Okay. Then out of this 360 degree, you have to subtract the value of the minor arc. Correct. This is the value of minor arc. Suppose it is 30 degree. So what will be the measure of the what will be the measure of the major arc? It will be 360 minus 30 degree. So you will be getting it as 330 degree. Okay. So in this way, you have to find the measure of the major arc. You will subtract the value of the minor arc from the 360 degree. Then few more properties. If you have a semicircular arc, that is if you have a circle and which is cut exactly into two halves, semicircles. So value of this arc, suppose we will take it as AXB. So value of this AXB as well as the AYB, both are the semicircle. So it is going to be 180 degree. And measure of a complete circle is 360 degree. This we already know. Then after seeing the measure of an arc, now let's see what is congruence of arcs. Okay, already we have seen the congruence of segments, angles, triangles. Now let's see what is meant by the congruence of the arcs. Now, two arcs are congruent if their measures and radii are equal, okay? Like for a same circle, all the radii are same, correct? So, if they're having, now in this particular circle, we are having O at center, radius is same. Like OA, OB, OC, OD, all are the radius of the same circle. So, they are going to be exactly same. Not only we need the radii same, but the values of the central angle, it also should be same, okay? Radius should be same and the value of the central angle should also be same. So that will be termed as the congruence of arc, or that time you can say आर्क ए बी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क सी डी. ओके, सो वॉट आर द टू एसेंशियल थिंग्स? द रेडियाई एंड द मेजर ऑफ देयर सेंट्रल एंगल शुड बी सेम, सो दैट टाइम यू कैन टर्म इट एज एन कॉन्ग्रुएंट आर्क. देन लेट सी वॉट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सम ऑफ मेजर्स ऑफ द आर्क्स. लाइक चिल्ड्रेन, हियर वी आर एबल टू सी मैनी आर्क्स, लाइक आर्क ए बी बी सी सी डी देन डी ई ए ई. नाउ इफ आई वॉन्ट मेजर ऑफ आर्क ए बी सी, ओके, आई वॉन्ट मेजर ऑफ द आर्क ए बी सी, तो हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट? इट विल बी इक्वल टू मेजर आर्क ए बी प्लस मेजर आर्क बी सी. ओके, सो सिंपली यू कैन एड इट एंड इट विल गिव यू आर्क ए सी. ओके, सो वट इज द नीड? इट शुड बी कंसिस्टेंट. आर्क ए बी प्लस बी सी विल गिव यू द आर्क ए सी, दैट इज दे शुड हैव द कॉमन एंड पॉइंट्स. ओके, देन एंड ओनली देन यू कैन फाइंड द और यू कैन डू द सम ऑफ मेजर्स ऑफ द आर्क. देन सिमिलरली इफ यू वॉन्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर्क ए डी, ओके, और आई मस्ट से आर्क ए ई डी, वॉट यू कैन डू? आर्क ए ई प्लस ई डी, दैट विल गिव यू द मेजर ऑफ बिगर आर्क ए ई डी. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ सम ऑफ मेजर्स ऑफ द आर्क्स. देन लेट्स सी द थियोरम्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू इट. नाउ द फर्स्ट थियोरम, द कॉर्ड्स विच आर करस्पॉन्डिंग टू द कॉन्ग्रुएंट आर्क्स ऑफ अ सर्कल और कॉन्ग्रुएंट सर्कल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट. लाइक चिल्ड्रन, सपोज यू आर हैविंग टू कॉन्ग्रुएंट आर्क्स, देन द कॉर्ड विच इज प्रेजेंट विथ इट, ओके, दे आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट. दिस प्रॉपर्टीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बाय द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ एग्जाम. योर एंटायर एक्सरसाइज, नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इज बेस्ड ऑन द सेम थिंग. सो योर सपोज यू आर हैविंग आर्क ए सी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क, सपोज आर्क ए पी सी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क डी क्यू ई, देन वॉट यू हैव टू शो दैट दिस आर्क ए सी इज गोइंग टू बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क डी ई, सॉरी कॉर्ड ए सी इज गोइंग टू बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क डी ई. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट. नाउ वॉट इज गिवन? इट इज गिवन दैट आर्क ए पी सी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क डी क्यू ई. देन वॉट वी हैव टू प्रूव? कॉर्ड ए सी. नाउ सी, इन दिस आर्क दैट कॉर्ड इज प्रेजेंट, सो वी हैव टू शो दैट दिस टू आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू बी सेम. सो वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट आर्क ए सी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू आर्क डी ई. ओके, टू प्रूव ऑल्सो वी रोट. Now let's start with the proof. Children, what we are going to do is we are going to join the points BA, BC, BD and BE. Now let's focus on the two triangles ABC and BED. Side AB is going to be congruent to side DB. What is the reason, children? They are the radii of same circle. Okay, so that is the reason why these two are congruent. Then you can say that another side you take, side BC will be congruent to side BE. Again the same reason, radii of the same circle. And angle ABC is congruent to angle DBE. Why these two angles are congruent, children? Why? Because we know that a measure of the arc is equal to the central angle, correct? If these two arcs are congruent, that means what? The central angles are same. This is 30. So this is also going to be 30. So that means what? Both the central angles are same. So you can write it as measures of the congruent arcs. Therefore, what did you get? You got the two triangles congruent by SAS test. Let's write it down. So you got the two triangles congruent by SAS test. Then already we know that chord AC will be congruent to chord DE. Why? Because it is the corresponding side of the congruent triangle. So that's what we wanted to prove, that if two arcs are congruent, then the side which is corresponding to it, that will also be congruent. This was the first theorem. Now let's see the second one. The corresponding arcs of the congruent chords of a circle are also congruent. Now children, it is given that already the two chords are congruent, that is you take it as PM, PQ and RS are congruent. Okay, why? Because it is given, congruent chords. Now you have to prove that PMQ arc is congruent to arc RNS. So what? It is very simple, children. You take the two triangles POQ and OSR. So PO will be congruent to OR, OQ will be congruent to OS, and already it is given that PQ is congruent to RS. Okay, it is given. So the two triangles became congruent by SSS test. Now, so that means what? Angle C, this POQ will be congruent to angle ROS. The reason for it will be corresponding angles of congruent triangles. And already we know that the value of the arc, here you can write angle POQ is congruent to angle ROS. Why? Because CACT. Then what is the value of this arc PMQ? It will be same as its corresponding central angle. And what will be the value of this arc RNS? It will also be same as like its central angle, that is ROS. So in short, what did we get? We got the arc PMQ congruent to arc RNS. So this is what we wanted to prove. Now children, after seeing the session, let's sum up what did we learn. And these are the points which we need to keep in mind in order to solve the next session or next practice set. Now see, we saw the definition of a central angle. So now what is a central angle? Central angle is an angle whose vertex lies at the center. Then the measure of an arc is always equal to the corresponding central angle. That also we have seen. Then when two arcs are of the same radius and same measure, then they are congruent. Okay. Then when only one point C is common to arc ABC and arc CDE of the same circle, then how to find the addition or the value of a major arc? You have to add the measure of the two small arcs, but they should have a common end point. Okay. Then this also we have seen. Then the two very important theorems. Chords of the same or congruent circles are equal if the related arcs are congruent. Okay. Then the last theorem, arcs of the same or congruent circles are equal if the related chords are congruent. So children, these are the things which you need to keep in mind while solving the exercise. I hope children, everyone has got the session very nicely. And if there is any difficulty or any doubt, please feel free to drop it into the comment section. And thank you for being so long.